So, earlier today I was digging through the vast deserts of Arabia and I found an ancient bottle. And when I went to polish it off, a genie came whooshing out of the top and he told me he'd grant me three. You know what? I'm gonna spare you. Today we're doing the genie in a bottle experiment. All right, let's science. The genie in a bottle experiment is a decomposition reaction. A decomposition reaction occurs when one reactant breaks down into two or more products. In its most basic terms, what this means is if I have compound AB, the reaction breaks it down into A and B. Not ABC, not AB plus C, not BD plus F. We had AB and now we have A and we have B. Like your couple friends who broke up last month, they're still there. They're just not together anymore. A good example of a decomposition reaction is the breaking down of hydrogen peroxide, chemical compound H2O2, from hydrogen peroxide into water and oxygen, and the breakdown of water to hydrogen and oxygen, which is not too far off from what we are doing. In fact, it's exactly what we're doing. Well, the first part anyway. The oxygen parts off as, well, oxygen. So long, oxygen. And the water is still water, it's just in a different state. It's expunged as water vapor. The big difference here is that we are using a catalyst in this reaction. And because we are using a catalyst, this experiment may also be referred to as a catalytic decomposition experiment, because it is a decomposition reaction, but aided by a catalyst. Now, when we refer to a catalyst, what we mean is a substance that increases the reaction rate, as in the time it takes a reaction to happen, but is not consumed in the course of the reaction. It's important to note that last part, not consumed in the course of the reaction. In the case of any reaction involving a catalyst, the reaction would happen on its own with or without the catalyst. It's just that the catalyst makes it happen way faster. Kind of like fast-forwarding time so you can see the reaction happen really fast. But you don't age, like in that one Adam Sandler movie. Now that I think about it, you could say, like in that one Adam Sandler movie, for just about anything. So, click. I was talking about click. Okay. So now we have a catalyst in this experiment, but what is our catalyst? Sodium iodide, in solid form. We'll get to why in a second. First, let's explain why sodium iodide in the first place. The answer is that sodium iodide oxidizes the hydrogen peroxide, allowing the oxygen to free itself from the tightly bonded grips of the hydrogen peroxide. It is a catalyst, so the amount does not really matter. The only reason to increase the amount is so that the initial reaction may be quicker. The extent of the reaction will just keep going until the peroxide's all used up. So it's doing something that would have already been done anyway. It's just speeding it along. Like when a boyfriend doesn't want to be shopping with his girlfriend. Believe me, she'll still do all of the shopping she came to do. She just may have to make some decisions and try things on a little faster than if he wasn't there. So I guess we could say here that the boyfriend is the catalyst. Now that we got all the players in this game, let's get to the actual experiment. I'm going to put on my chemistry teacher hat here and give you the full script. Okay, we have this bottle here. It's wrapped in foil. There's a genie in this bottle and he wants to get out. Wink. To release him, you'll just pull this cork and he will come out and he'll grant you wishes. Before the genie is released, I'm going to need a student, you're fine, come on up here, to come and touch the bottle. They come up, they feel it. Is this cold? Yes, it's cold. Room temperature, whatever. The bottle is currently cold. After that, I say, kazalazazam, and I pull the cork. Vapor will start to shoot from the bottle. I will say, oh no, this genie's really mad. Everybody hit the deck. And I'll flick the lights on and off. I'll turn on my lasers. Okay, I'm not trying to cause a riot in the classroom. I'm just trying to make a point. In all reality, the water vapor will go and go and keep going and keep going. And when it finally runs out of steam, pun intended, I will ask the same student to come up and touch the genie bottle. He, she will. Now it's hot, not cold, not room temperature.
But why?
Then I'll go through the same experiment again, but without the aluminum foil so the students, and of course you, my lovely audience, can see what is really happening.
Wait, just one scientific second, Batman. Sodium iodide is white. This powder is gray. What gives?
Well, actually, what we're talking about here is sodium iodide. What we're looking at here is manganese dioxide. Both can work as a catalyst for the genie in a bottle experiment. I've already started talking about sodium iodide, so I'm just gonna keep on with that. Just know what we're looking at here is manganese dioxide. You can chew me out in the comments. This produces the same type of reaction, a decomposition reaction with a catalyst. Before you even stepped foot into my lab, I took some toilet paper and I put the powder form sodium iodide, our catalyst, in it. tied it off with some string, and closed the string in the stopper, hovering ever so slightly over the hydrogen peroxide so that the experiment would be triggered when I open the stopper, therefore dropping the catalyst into the hydrogen peroxide, creating the steam and making it look like it comes alive when the stopper is removed. And that is why we wanted our sodium iodide in powder form, which by the way looks really cool when it hits the hydrogen peroxide. Do we have footage on that? Yeah, roll some footage on that. Why would you deprive anyone from seeing that twice? So I'm going to show it to you again. Rewind the tape. So satisfying. We actually have a satisfying video you should check out, by the way. We gotta get back to this. So what we really have here is an experiment that's part magic trick, part chemistry experiment. Wait, what? Chemistry isn't magic. The only difference between chemistry and magic is eyeliner, children. Okay, hold up. True, chemistry isn't magic, but it uses a few pages from magic to prove science. First of all, we have the member of the audience bit, wherein someone who could never be in on the trick confirm what is happening, both with the exothermic reaction and the pulling off of the top. And it uses parts of the experiment you can't see, namely the sodium iodide, catalyst being dropped into the solution without the audience knowing that it sets the experiment off into high gear. So between the water vapor and the aluminum foil, I'd call that the smoke and mirrors here, wouldn't you? And let's not forget that while a volumetric flask is the best instrument for this experiment, it does look a whole lot like a Genie bottle. Well, at least the closest thing you can find in a lab, especially when covered with aluminum foil. But remember the audience participation? The student who comes up and verifies the flask is indeed hotter after the reaction? He/she is not like the lady who gets sawed in half. He/she is not a plant in the crowd to hoodwink us. The flask is in fact hot, which means it is, you guessed it, an exothermic reaction. Exothermic reaction meaning heat is a byproduct of the reaction. Usually exothermic reactions indicate that electrons are transferred from one atom or molecule to another. That is not the case here. In fact, it generates so much heat that the water, when decomposed out of the hydrogen peroxide, does so as vapor, not a liquid. Think about that. When you see water vapor, it's like when your grandmother's making tea. The water is that hot right now. But to note, it's not just water vapor shooting out of that Genie bottle, it's also oxygen. Remember our couple that is no more? Well, they may no longer be an item, but they're going out the same door. The door here being the opening in the volumetric flask, never to go on a date together again. Although they'll probably find someone much better suited to them down the road. So there you have it, the Genie in a bottle catalytic decomposition reaction, boyfriend and girlfriend who are no longer together, magic trick in the chemistry lab experiment. Wow, that is a mouthful. Maybe that's why we just stick with Genie in a bottle. That's way easier to remember. Leave us a like right there or wherever it is if you like the video, and tell me in the comments what you would do with three wishes. I know what I would do and I'm not gonna tell you. All right, that's it for me being chemistry teacher. I'm out.